Dang it, Mo. I can't stop. I keep running into everything except the kitchen sink.
Man, tell me about it. These toe stops suck. I tried all of them. They feel like plastic and they keep popping off the stems.
I cannot stop.
I wish somebody would help us. Help us.
Do you hear that?
I think we're needed.
Captain Antic, can you help me?
Antic skate boots?
Reckless wheels?
I wish somebody would help us. Help us.
It's okay, guys. I've got this one.
Wow! It's the Gumballer!
Try these Gumball toe stops. All natural rubber, no dyes, traction for any surface, and these will never pop off.
Jeez, thanks, mister!
This commercial is brought to you by Green Monster Roller Sports, Gumball Toe Stops, and Derby Skins.
You're right. Okay.
Oh, hey, all right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome. As once again, we kind of just pop on in here. It's fantastic. Welcome. We are here in Asheville, North Carolina, at the U.S. Cellular Arena, home of the Blue Ridge Roller Girls. And, yeah, it's time. It's time, once again, for the next playoff tournament. This is the third of four WFTDA playoff tournaments this year. My name is John Maddening. This is Inspector Muffin.
How's it going? We've got Denver. We have the Ohio Roller Girls. London, our first international team to play at Champs. Texas, Philly, and Angel City have all already punched their tickets, John, to Milwaukee in November.
Yeah, interesting note about that, too. This is the first time that three teams, half of the teams that have already punched their ticket, have never been to championships before. So this is going to make for an interesting championship round in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 2 months.
Yeah, and it hasn't just been like when the new ranking systems came out, we thought it was going to be the 1, 2, 3 seed, maybe the 4 is going to squeeze in there to make their way into champs because, one of the top 3 might sometimes loses. But, it's been really different this season with the new ranking system. Teams are benefiting, like the Ohio Roller Girls. They came in as a 6 seed at Fort Wayne 2 weeks ago. They upset the number 3 seed arch rival. Then they go on to upset the number 2 seed. Then they got handed to them a little bit by the Denver Roller Dolls. But you know what? Ohio has punched their ticket. After 8 seasons, a first wave team with the WFTDA, they are now going to championships.
Yeah, and this one, the pundits are kind of saying it's not going to happen this time. The top 4 teams here, we've got Gotham, we've got Windy City, we've got Rocky Mountain, and we've got Minnesota. Pretty much the people on
the internet
are saying that it's going to be 3 of those 4 teams, but you never know, especially given the last two weeks, anything can happen. I hate saying it, it's a cliche, but literally, I was shocked by numerous bouts, numerous upsets over this past few couple weeks.
Yeah, and just like, Gotham is obviously the clear favorite to win not only this tournament, but the Hydro Trophy again. But, think about it. Like you said, Maddening, Rocky Mountain, Minnesota, Windy City, one of those teams isn't going to go to champs.
Yeah.
Barring a colossal collapse, like delayed flights for Gotham or something, one of those 3 teams that I just mentioned aren't going to go to champs this year.
For the first time in years.
Yeah.
it's pretty crazy. It's pretty nuts. It'll be fun to watch, though. We got 3 fantastic full days of roller derby for you. The best teams in the world are right here. And it's going to be just fun to watch. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in to WFTDA.TV. Thanks for listening, those of you at home that are listening on the audio stream, the free audio stream. Remember, it's only $12 for the weekend to upgrade to the video stream.
Yeah, you've got four great initial round games today that we know who's already going to play. Our first bout is Nashville versus Oklahoma Victory. Following them at noon is going to be Columbia versus Houston, and then it's going to be Minnesota versus Steel City from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and then Windy City going up against the 6 seed Madison, a team with good history against each other. And, actually, a little bit of trivia. If I said, give me the team with the best record against number 1 seed Gotham, who would you say it was?
I believe that's Madison.
It is Madison. Yeah,
the Mad Rollin' Dolls.
Yeah, Madison with a 2-2 record. So is it one of those lower seeds? Could it be Steel City? Could it be Madison? Could it be Columbia, who was actually ranked 41st in the WFTDA and has now made their way into the Division I playoffs?
All right, we are going to get this thing started off with the national anthem, and then we're going to throw it up to Big Bad Betty Voodoo and Lightning Slim.
Thank you.
so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
morning, everyone, on WFTDA.TV. My name is Lightning Slim. I am joined here by my good friend, Big Daddy Voodoo. We are here in beautiful Asheville, North Carolina. First in flight, and first in flight for you today. We have the ninth seed, Oklahoma Victory Dolls All-Stars. They will be playing the Music City All-Stars of Nashville, the eighth seed in this first bout of the Division I tournament here in Asheville.
That's right. Finally, the world looking at the mountains for a change. Usually it's 5 or so hours for anyone here in the northwest North Carolina to get to some derby of this level, and here we are, bringing it to the world.
And it looks like they're getting off to a quick start.
Wow.
You see there in the red, that is the Oklahoma Victory Dolls, in the blue, Nashville. Oh, yeah, still getting set up. We're going to run through the rosters quickly here for you. As I said, in the blue, we have Nashville. They're the eighth seed. Number 10 will be Union Jack You Up. Number 13, Leanne Crimes. Number 137, Big Banger. 1969, Hippie Kaye. 220 Volt, Electrical. 226 Terabyte. 308, Britches and Hose. 318, Four Leaf Roller. 48 Volt, Phantom Power. 5'3", Lady Fury. 757 Morgan Grinder, 77 Danny Doom, 8 gigabyte zip drive, and DV8 Stella Live.
Your number 9 seed Oklahoma Victory Dolls are ranked 34th in the WFTDA rankings. 00 is Mount Crushmore, 04 is Blood Bjorn Pathogen, number 11 is Genetees, number 12 Check 1-2, 13-13 is Princess Panic, 14 T-Pain, 20 is Jammin' Jane, 21 Esha Spades, 54-46 is Trenchtown Rockette. 55, Dolly Dynamite. 7, Jim Reaper. 777 is Dez Dispenser. Number 82, Molly Menace. And 999 is Donka Shame. And we are just about ready to launch this thing.
The winner of this bout will go on at 8 p.m. today. Perhaps a dubious honor for the victory of this game that will face the Gotham Girls.
So we have the Jammers lining up on the line, about ready to go for Oklahoma Victory Dolls. It's going to be T-Pain on the line, and she's going to be jamming against, I believe that's 308.
318, four-leaf roller.
My mistake, sorry. They're going to line up on the Antique Boots start line. And we are just waiting for the signal from the officials to take off.
Just a few seconds remaining. Of course, Nashville, having been to the championships before, Oklahoma, this is their first time qualifying for the WFTDA playoffs.
That's right. Nashville, I mean, they've faced against a few of the teams that we're going to have here this weekend. They've played against Rocky Mountain, Minnesota, Steel City, Columbia. And we are ready to launch. And we're off.
Bodies tumble to the track almost immediately. That is the Jammer for Oklahoma, but still, no lead jammer yet declared, as both of the ladies with stars on helmets get involved. There is your lead jammer. It is for Oklahoma.
That's going to be T-Pain taking your lead jammer.
T-Pain almost a half a track on her opponents. The pack picking up speed. Oklahoma trying to take control early in this bout.
Pack getting a little bit strung out. They're going to reform it.
T-Pain colliding with her own teammate, tries to move through on the inside line, takes a hit from the pivot of Nashville, forced to recycle herself to the rear of the pack.
T-Pain had a pretty good head of steam coming up, but she gets forced that inside, and now Nashville's trying to sit on her.
Four-leaf roller has escaped the pack. You will see her coming in on the right side of your screen. However, it is T-Pain for Oklahoma. She is on her scoring pass inside the pack. She puts up 4 points and calls off the jam.
It's going to be a steady start for both teams. Not a lot of explosive leading.
Taking her turn on the jammer line in the red for Oklahoma, number 4. That's Blood Bjorn Pathogen. And in the blue for Nashville, number 308, Britches and Hose.
I hope you're keeping up with your cheeseballs.com bearing bracket bonanza. And we're going to fire up this jam.
Coming through Oklahoma, lead jam once again. Number 4, Blood Bjorn Pathogen. She's way out ahead and lead jammer. Once again, pack moving quickly for both teams. Neither team exerting speed control as of yet, but we're only two jams deep with Oklahoma with a 4-point lead.
Oklahoma seems to be sitting on the one Nashville blocker, trying to hold the control of that pack from the back. Little arm whip.
Taking a hit, Blood Bjorn Pathogen calls off the jam. In turn number 2 there, she falls, picks up a couple of points there, and Nashville puts up 2 of their own.
Adam Wheels is a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA.
Four-leaf roller taking another turn on the jammer line. She faces a new opponent for Oklahoma, number 12. It is Check, 1-2.
27 minutes, 29 seconds left to go in this first half. 2-6, Oklahoma currently in the lead. The jam starts and is immediately stopped.
Yeah, I do believe the jam did not get a chance to start. That is a timeout being called by Oklahoma.
I saw Check 1-2 skate over to her bench and pick up that jammer helmet cover and return via the inside line.
That might have been the important thing she lacked, that her coach decided to burn off a timeout in order to get that into her possession.
Oops, you're not going to pick up any points if you're not going to be wearing that star helmet cover. She would have just been skating around for her health.
Likely a timeout well spent.
Both teams with a look of intensity. Nashville, a fairly young lineup. They have a lot of people that are fresh to the team over the last year or so. Oklahoma, this being their first showing at a playoff for the WFTDA. I'm quite interested to see what Oklahoma has. I did some research. I tried to find some bout footage. Had a little bit of trouble doing my research on Oklahoma, but.
You're seeing them in the flesh now, Daddy. Four-leaf roller pushed off to one side, but number 12 for Oklahoma, Check 1-2, is recycled directly to the back. That allows four-leaf roller to move to the front of the pack. She takes a hit there from double zero, Mount Crushmore. No lead jammer yet declared. A bit of a mosh pit in the center of the pack.
And those Nashville blockers, they drop back to hold her back as long as they could. But here she comes through the pack, picking up lead jammer. It's going to be number 12, Check 1-2.
Check 1-2 in the free and clear, coming around, but that pack moving at great speed as it has early on in this bout. Check 1-2 cautiously approaching the rear of the pack. She's looking for the smoothest route through her opponents, and that's some smooth skating there as she puts up a full 5-point pass.
Cutting track is going to be called on four-leaf roller. She's going to be heading to the notorious RED penalty box.
Check 1-2 has come around the mountain again. Another 5 points for Oklahoma, so widening their lead.
So far, Oklahoma's 3-for-3 in getting lead jammer.
Struck down in the center of the pack. Check 1-2 now being blocked by Lady Fury.
What a hit.
A bit of a tap dance there.
I just saw I could see the impact when they kind of sandwiched her and she went down.
Indeed. However, she outweights them. Squeezes her way through the pack, and she's come around for another pass inside the pack once more. Chooses the outside route, and that is smooth like butter for her. And picking up another 5 before the jam is called. Oklahoma extending their lead early on with 25 minutes remaining. They have a score of 26 to Nashville's 2.
Oklahoma picking up 20 points in that jam. Nashville's going to start this next jam with not only a blocker in the box, but that jammer is going to be in the box. So Oklahoma is going to start on the power jam.
It is number 20, Jammin' Jane, hoping to live up to her name.
Jammin' Jane getting low on that jammer line.
But she is immediately blocked. There's a three wall of blue in front of her. She squeezes through on the inside. She has lead now.
That Oklahoma pack, they were going to hold their position on that line, force Nashville to let her get to the edge of that engagement zone where they had to let her go.
Jammin' Jane now on a scoring pass inside the pack, taking some physical punishment. Her teammates lag behind to extend that pack for her, but she falls.
And you can hear the crowd cheering as Nashville return their jammer to the box. It's four-leaf roller.
But Jammin' Jane hears that roar as well, calls off the jam before four-leaf roller can get engaged with that pack, and that jam is in the bag.
Nashville's going to end that jam with one player standing in the penalty box.
Taking her first turn on the jammer line in this contest, number 10 in the blue for Nashville Union, Jack You Up. She faces number 55 for Oklahoma, Dolly Dynamite.
So far, Oklahoma's had five different jammers. It's quite a variety they're fielding.
Dolly Dynamite, Union Jack You Up, jammers of the right now. Dolly Dynamite inside the center of the pack. Union Jack You Up has been recycled to the rear. Dolly Dynamite pushed to the inside. Lady Fury doing some excellent blocking work once again. Dolly Dynamite recycled now as Lady Fury pulls her back. Union Jack You Up at the front of the pack. She is lead jammer.
I was talking to our house announcers, Yiddish Invasion and Daddy Homemaker, announcers for Nashville. They were saying they're going to hold on to Union Jack You Up as kind of a special secret weapon.
Well, the secret might be out, Big Daddy.
That's going to be the first lead jammer for Nashville, I'd say so.
Union Jaguar, she blew a tire as she came out of the pack and slipped, but managed to regain her skates. She caught up with the pack, but she saw that Dolly Dynamite was coming up in the rearview mirror, and therefore nothing neither way on that jam.
Rydell Skates is the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. And again, that jammer line getting up close and everyone getting up close and tidy. The Antic Boots start line. We want to thank Antic for sponsoring our start line today.
And yet more new jammers on the line. Zip Drive faces off against, that's number one for Oklahoma. My apologies, that is number 14, T-Pain, and she is going to the notorious RED penalty box.
A big break for Nashville. They're going to pick up the power jam and Zip Drive, this being her first jam of the game. No pressure, Zip Drive.
Zip Drive outweights her opponent, makes her way to the front of the pack. She is lead jammer. Now Zip Drive, her teammates lagging behind to break that pack open for her. Zip Drive facing a wall of three. She just carefully negotiates, trying not to get too handsy with the blockers, and she is through with a grand slam.
The referees were calling no pack. Pack is here. No pack. Pack is here. It worked out in Nashville's advantage as she snuck through.
Zip Drive tries to sneak through on the inside, is briefly deterred by the blocking of Oklahoma. She takes a hefty hit there from Trenchtown Rockette.
Excellent control of the pack by Nashville as they're trying to push and pull and create that situation that creates the no pack that lets their jammer through. Zip Drive's going to clear the pack.
You're right, Big Daddy. Oklahoma was blocking furiously, but it is Nashville who had control of the speed and the composition of that pack, and that has allowed them to draw a little bit nearer to Oklahoma. Nashville now with a score of 12 in the double digits. Oklahoma with 30, 20 more minutes remain.
They're going to pick up 10 points in that last jam. For all your printing needs, hit up printcographics.com.
A little bit of time remaining on the power jam for Nashville. Four-leaf roller filling that jammer roll. She tries the outside route, takes a bit of punishment, moves her way to the front of the pack, and now picks up lead jammer.
T-Pain gets held up in the back of the pack. She's forced to the outside, and she has to come in the long way to re-engage.
T-Pain taking a hit there from Danny Doom at the rear of the pack. But T-Pain recovers, comes through on the inside. She's now skating in the free and open spaces, and that forces four-leaf roller, sees her coming, has to call off the jam. And that is 3 points for Nashville.
Oklahoma still up by 15 points, 20 minutes, 39 seconds left to go in the first half. CruiseSkateShop.com, offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007.
For their respective teams on the jammer line, Zip Drive and Blood Bjorn Pathogen.
I like that name a lot.
Me too. Both X's, Zip Drive, number 8 gigabyte, and she has moved to the front of the pack. One defender to beat. A no pack declared. She is through. Lead jammer, Zip Drive of Nashville.
Oklahoma Roller Warriors had released their last player from the penalty box at the beginning of that last jam, but they're going to replace it with another player along with Nashville at the beginning of this one.
Zip Drive on a scoring pass inside the pack, moves her way to the front, trying to finish that pass, but she decides to take the path of caution while she is still inside the pack, calls off the jam, but Nashville gaining on Oklahoma. Oklahoma remains at a score of 30, Nashville a score of 19, 19 and a half minutes remain.
Jim Reaper going to the box for Oklahoma. That's going to be an out-of-play penalty that she pulls. In the box for Nashville Roller Girls, it's going to be Electric Cal. She was called for a multiplayer block. And there's the whistle. The pack is rolling again.
Union Jack, you up. Firmly ensconced within the pack, but sneaking through on the inside line. It is the jammer of Oklahoma, number 12. Check 1-2. She is lead jammer.
As we do a little shifting.
Check 1-2. Being chased by Union Jack, you up. Both of them equally chasing a very fast-moving pack. Check 1-2 momentarily gets the upper hand on Union Jack. You up, both of them inside the pack now. Union Jack, you up, moves her way to the front of the pack.
And you can see Nashville just turning on the speed, accelerating away, trying to pull that pack with them.
And these jammers have 4 apiece. Their coach is electing to let them trade points and just skate for this jam.
I noticed that happening a lot last week in Richmond. If you have any thoughts on the game, you can talk to us at talk2WFTDA. That's #, for your hashtag, talk2WFTDA on twitter.com.
Union Jack, you up, getting some jammer support from her blocker, Electric Hal, at the front of the pack. Union Jack, you up, in danger of being recycled, but skates firmly on.
A little bit of a tangle is going to collect Union Jack, you up, and a couple other skaters.
Bodies fall to the track in turn number 4. You see the jammer for Oklahoma, check 1-2, a little slow to get up, perhaps a little out of breath. That jam went for quite some time before that collision at the end.
Fast Girl Skates, our mission is educating skaters. Get schooled.
10 points separate these teams. Nashville 26, Oklahoma 36, 17 minutes remaining in the first half of play. Jammin' Jane returns to the jammer line for Oklahoma. She faces 4 leaf roller. Away they go. Jammin' Jane makes it to the front of the pack but is knocked to her knees. 4 leaf roller is not lead, but she is the jammer in front and has almost a full track on Jammin' Jane, forcing her to call it off.
A big thumbs up from the Oklahoma jammer to the crowd. Scotland's first and only bricks and mortar online roller derby store. It's Gallus. That's Scottish for wild, a rascal deserving to be hanged. That's fifthblockersskates.co.uk.
Britches and Hose returns to the jammer line for Nashville.
Britches and Hose turning on the speed and claiming lead jammer right off the bat.
Her opposite number, Dolly Dynamite, inside the pack. Grabs a bit of a jersey whip from her teammate, and now she is in the free and open spaces. But it is Britches and Hose on a scoring pass, chasing the pack. You will see there at the bottom of your screen. Oh, she is struck down. Britches and Hose absolutely leveled by Molly Menace.
And that was the 7th in a row lead jammer claimed by Nashville. 36 Oklahoma, 26 Nashville, 15:53 left to go in the first half.
Molly Menace put a very quick end to a break for a scoring pass by Britches and Hose by putting shoulder to her right there in turn number one. Just struck her down. Tremendous blocking display there. Four-leaf roller returns to the jammer line for Nashville.
Bruce Skate Noose, the original over-the-shoulder roller skate holder.
T-Pain scooting through on the inside for Nashville. One to beat. She's got to let her go. T-Pain, lead jammer for Oklahoma.
You saw the Nashville blocker throwing those hands up, but it's not good enough. She's going to go to the penalty box. That's Union Jack you up heading to the box. Nashville currently, it looks like a full house. Yes, Union Jack you up has been waved off. Currently in the penalty box, we have Hippie Kai Ye, Taro Bite, and Four Leaf Roller.
4 points on the board for T-Pain as she comes through the pack. She's coming around again. And meanwhile, inside the pack, Esha Spades puts the hurt on Four Leaf Roller. And T-Pain coming around the outside. The pack starting to pick up speed again. T-Pain inside, trying to find a way around the pivot of Nashville. Tries to go from inside to outside. Takes cover behind her own blocker, and then T-Pain makes a break for the inside line. And she is through.
Union Jack you up, reported for her penalty, and the last blocker, Yippie Kaye, was released from the box right at the end of that jam. Check out photos from the WFTDA photo booth sponsored by Viva Las Vegas Skates. You can find that at facebook.com/WFTDA. They're going to be taking those photos during the last two bouts of the evening.
Blood Bjorn Pathogen. Let's try that again in full. She faces off against Britches and Hose. Here they go. Blood Bjorn Pathogen. Number four for Oklahoma, lead jammer inside the pack. Britches and Hose trying to avoid a hit, knocked to her knees, springs back up like a rubber ball.
Jenna Tees has just a great blocking technique where she hops right in front of that Nashville blocker, flips around, and it's almost like she's trying to discombobulate him a little bit. Is that a word?
It's a word to me, and I think that's exactly what she was doing, Big Daddy. Britches and Hose now skating in the free and open spaces. Oh, tripped up.
And
Bloodburn Pathogen takes a spill, but once again, these girls seem to be mad out of rubber and springs. She's back up again for a 4-point pass.
While that was going on, Electric Cow pulls a cutting track penalty. She's going to go to the box to join Union Jack you up.
Britches and Hose now on a scoring pass, recycled to the rear. Bloodburn Pathogen continues to score coming around the outside, and that is a full five.
Britches and Hose on that approach, on that straightaway, was forced out by Molly Menace. Still trying to escape the pack.
Multiplayer block assessed there. It's 777. Dez Dispenser going to the box. And 4 points on the board for Britches and Hose as she makes her way through the pack. But now these jammers are trading points. Oklahoma in the lead. This is to their advantage.
4-4.
12.5 minutes remain in the first half of play. And Bloodburn Pathogen managing to keep her wheels on the track as she avoids a collision there. 4 more points on the board. Britches and Hose struck down.
She's going to take a little bit of a barrel roll. She had to crawl around before she got caught up. She lost a little bit of time reaching that pack.
And that is Danny Doom laying the boom there. Jammer penalty.
In the box right now for Nashville is going to be Electric Cow and Lady Fury.
And Nashville will have the power start.
That was a misconduct call that you were talking about just a second ago.
A misconduct sending the jammer of Oklahoma to the penalty area. And this will allow Nashville another chance to catch up. They've played catch up once before in this bout with 11.5 minutes remaining. Nashville at a score of 37. Oklahoma at 64. Zip drive standing solo on that jammer line for the power start. And it appears we have a brief official timeout.
This official timeout is brought to you by the Green Monster. GRNMNSTR.com.
I stand corrected. That is an official review called by Oklahoma.
So I'm told by folks that are familiar with the Nashville team that they've been working really hard on their pack work. They want to keep those heads on pivots. They want to work a little bit harder. They felt they were falling a little behind the curve on on their pack work. They've worked really hard, and so far today, they've had a lot of control over that pack. You'll see them stretching the pack out, forcing those out of plays, getting those jammers through.
Big Daddy Voodoo, I would certainly agree. Pack control being one of their strengths for the ladies in blue today. If that's something they've been working on, it seems to have been working. Of course, these two teams, only two of the 212 member leagues of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. There are also 83 apprentice leagues working their way up. And all these teams with their eyes on the prize, the Hydra Trophy, which will be handed out in Milwaukee, Wisconsin on the weekend of November 8th through 10th at the U.S. Cellular Arena at the championship tournament. It's coming up. I know most of you folks out there have either booked your trip or booked some time off to check it out online here at WFTDA.tv.
You know, it's so inspiring. As I was around for the formation of my league, I watched it grow. We joined the WFTDA, and every step of that journey for these teams is a journey of excitement. You want to join the WFTDA. You join the WFTDA. You want to move up, and you want to increase that ranking. You increase that ranking to a point where you're going to make one of the playoffs. You make the playoffs. It can't get any better than that. You make it to the championships. They say that derby is a lifestyle, and I think that's a bit of an exaggeration, but there is a certain electricity that you get from all of the people that are in this room right now on their derby journey.
Absolutely, Big Daddy. You could say that derby is a lifestyle if lifestyle is defined as excitement.
Right.
Because I see a lot of smiles on the faces of these ladies on the track. They're having a great time. As you said, the goal is to make your way to the championships. Nashville has been there twice before to the championship tournament in 2010 and 2011. This is Oklahoma's first trip to the playoffs. Let us see what transpires as we begin again. 11 and a half minutes remaining. Nashville on the power jam. Here comes Zip Drive. Knocked to her knees. Quickly recovering. Pack control, as we were just saying, by Nashville. And it looks like we have a report from that official review by Captain Lou Obama.
Yeah, Oklahoma Victory Dolls were challenging the misconduct call on Bloodbjorn Pathogen. The call will stand. She will serve that minute in the penalty box.
And that means that Zip Drive, a little opportunity to play here. She has lead jammer status and has already picked up 5 points. Cautiously coming around again, perhaps visualizing a route through the four blockers in front of her. Now she gets some jammer support for number 226. That's Terabyte. Falls, takes a spill as she is very effectively blocked by Oklahoma. They drag her backwards, making sure she can't take full advantage of the power jam situation, and she calls it off. She wants to get fresh legs on that track.
Still alive, had pulled a out of play penalty about halfway through that jam. Talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more.
Jammers of the right now for Oklahoma. It is check 1-2 for Nashville. Four-leaf roller. Four-leaf roller makes an early play, but she is knocked to the inside. That's Jenna Tees doing the damage there. She pulls her backwards, but that is followed by check 1-2 being recycled to the back of the pack. Both jammers having a tough time getting out of the pack thus far. No lead jammer yet declared, but it is check 1-2. Moving out front, she is not lead.
I didn't catch the call that prevented her from earning lead jammer.
Check 1-2 coming around. Nevertheless, on a scoring pass, it looks like she is threatening to lap four-leaf roller. She does so through the pack. Leanne Crimes goes to the notorious RED penalty box. 4 points on the board. No, it is a full five.
5 points.
For check 1-2.
The pack, again, kind of falling apart. That's a bad choice of words. Stretching out a little bit as Nashville exerts more of that control, trying to keep the pack where they want it.
Pivot-to-pivot collision at the front of the pack. Mount Crushmore trying to control speed, but she is stymied, as you were saying, Big Daddy, by this pack control of Nashville. Just as four-leaf roller comes out of the pack, the jam is called to a finish. And we are almost at 8.5 minutes remaining in the first half of play. Oklahoma with a score of 69, Nashville 47.
RidellSkates.com, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance.
And after a bit of jammer experimentation with what looks to be a deep roster, Nashville's coach going with the hot hand and puts Zip Drive up again.
Zip Drive had a bit of success her last time on the line. They're hoping they could carry it through, because even though Nashville is showing that excellent control of the pack, it always comes down to the points. And right now, 47-69, Nashville really needs to put those jammers in overdrive and pick up those points.
And Zip Drive, after getting pinballed around the inside of the pack for a while, makes her way to the front. She is lead jammer. And now also escaping the pack and skating in the free and open spaces, Jammin' Jane.
I believe that's going to be a back blocking call on Jammin' Jane.
Inside the pack, Zip Drive on a scoring pass.
Doom. It was a back block on Doom.
Hefty hit there by number 7. Gem Reaper puts a hit on Zip Drive. Zip Drive decides she has done enough damage, picks up a couple more points for Nashville, and calls off the jam. Now 20 points separate these teams, 49-69 in Oklahoma's favor. 7 minutes remaining in the first half of play in this, the first bout, the first of many exciting bouts at the Asheville Division I tournaments of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
Lining up on the Green Monster start line, Union Jack You Up is going to be jamming against Dolly Dynamite for the Oklahoma Victory Dolls.
Dolly Dynamite, number 55 in the red, makes her way to the front of the pack. Union Jack You Up, a more diminutive jammer, sneaking through the center of the pack. She finds the inside line and grabs it. Oh, a swing and a miss by Jenna Tease, which would have leveled Union Jack You Up if it had connected. But she's now skating free. That Union Jack You Up, lead jammer.
That could be one of the lessons that we learned in the early derby. Those big hits, if they work, they're awesome. But if you swing and you miss, you're going to lose a little bit of time and maybe some valuable track position.
It is a risk-reward equation. Zip Drive inside the pack, taking a track cutting penalty. Now a power jam for Oklahoma.
Union Jack You Up, she was skating through, and she actually looked almost nonchalant as she skated out of bounds and came right back in, pulling the cutting track.
An opportunity for Oklahoma here. Oh, an opportunity which may have been cut short by a hefty, hefty hit there by the defenders of Nashville, striking down Dolly Dynamite. That was Terabyte. Terabyte has been strong for Nashville in this contest, but Dolly Dynamite recovers from that hit and puts up 5 points.
Pack's hitting the brakes. They're going to take it easy and try to hold up Dolly Dynamite's advance. Nashville looking to slow it down and keep control. Dolly Dynamite afraid she was going to pull that cutting track on the outside.
Doing it on one skate. Dolly Dynamite comes back in fair and goes from outside to inside. A bit of a slalom there for Dolly Dynamite. And she's picking up points for Oklahoma. 5 more in the bag. They're trying to reestablish that early lead they had over Nashville. Her teammates conga lined off to one side.
They want to make room to let their jammer get through. The jammer may have to do a little bit more work. But here they come as the cavalry trying to open up that top, a hole in that top wall.
Doom throwing another hit on Dolly Dynamite. Dolly Dynamite is a tall skater, so she's taking a lot of punishment to the hip and thigh. But she's maintaining her skates. You see there, Eye of the Tiger on Dolly Dynamite there as she surveys the track. I think she's done some heavy lifting during that jam, Big Daddy.
3 points were picked up on the last pass on that jam. On the line for Nashville is going to be four-leafed roller. She's going to be jamming against number 14, T-Pain. That was 18 points picked up by Oklahoma on that last jam.
You see there on your screen the skaters in blue. You see communication on that antic jammer line as they put their plan together right before that whistle blows. And now the action underway. Four-leaf roller gets clearance from her pivot. That's Lady Fury. But it is T-Pain coming out in front. T-Pain, lead jammer for Oklahoma. And four-leaf roller has been recycled. A wall in front of her. Lady Fury clears for her again. But four-leaf roller recycled. T-Pain skating cautiously. She is just matching speed with the pack. Electrical struck to the center of the oval.
Nashville right now with one skater in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
The jam called off after 2 points put on the board by Oklahoma. That will bring their score to 89. They have widened their lead to 40 points. Nashville sitting at 49. And single digits remaining, just 3.5 minutes in the first half of play. Britches and Hose, number 308, returns to the jammer line for Nashville. She faces number 4, Blood Bjorn Pathogen.
And that last jam features the largest lead so far.
There is the whistle. An immediate
Ooh,
scrum.
A little bump and run.
Indeed, jammer to jammer. Bloodbjorn Pathogen putting out her opposite number and making a play to the front, doing it by herself, although her blockers had set up an effective avenue for Bloodbjorn Pathogen to escape from that pack. She is your lead jammer.
I think Britches and Hose, I think she was a victim of a little bit of a setup there. She's knocked out, and then those Oklahoma skaters locked her right in. And that's going to give a big advantage to Oklahoma as they take lead jammer.
Britches and Hose runs over the pivot of Oklahoma, and that allows her exit from the pack. But inside the pack on her scoring pass, Bloodbjorn Pathogen making her way to the front. She takes a hit from Union Jack, you up, pushed to the outside, but maintains the integrity of the track and calls off the jam.
Bloodbjorn Pathogen, she'll take a hit, and she just kind of contorts with it. She takes the hit and just brushes it off and comes around.
Indeed, what happens to her upper body stays on her upper body and does not affect her skates. Returning to the jammer line, we have Zip Drive and Check 1-2.
Adam Wheels is a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA, adamwheels.com.
You see Zip Drive standing calmly with eyes closed, waiting for the whistle.
Maybe she's trying to find her inner peace.
A visualization exercise, right. Indeed. No lead jammer yet declared. One to beat at the front for Check 1-2. She does so. Check 1-2, lead jammer for Oklahoma. Zip Drive firmly inside the pack. She is recycled. She's looking for jammer support. Gets it from her blocker there. But the front wall of Oklahoma reforms in front of her.
Yeah, that Oklahoma, those Oklahoma blockers are always busy. They target, they go for just one precise hit. And so far it's working out pretty well for them as they're up 93-49 over Nashville.
Wow. Check 1-2 coming around the outside on a scoring pass, but a track cutting penalty. No, that is not to Check 1-2, fortunately for Oklahoma. Picking up 5 points.
Currently, Nashville has one player in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
That's Lady Fury taking a seat. Meanwhile, inside the pack, Zip Drive trying to re-engage, but a wall of blockers from Oklahoma in front of her coming around that self-same wall as they just duck to one side to let her through on the outside line. That's Check 1-2, putting up another grand slam for Oklahoma.
Another big jam for Oklahoma Victory Dolls. They were seeded ninth coming into this tournament.
Obviously a team who wants to prove that they belong here at this level. A one-to-one matchup on paper, of course, ninth seed versus eighth, but both teams looking to make a statement. A statement of 5 points there by Check 1-2, and she looks to her bench for guidance and calls off the jam.
You got to wonder, where does the hunger play into this? Does the team that's never been to a tournament, is there a hunger, a want, an edge that they might get over a team that's a little bit more experienced with making tournaments?
So, as we go into the half, Oklahoma with a score of 108, just dipping into three-digit territory. Nashville remaining at a score of 49. Of course, that is merely the first half of play. Another half hour of track time remaining for both of these teams. And what I see developing here, Big Daddy Voodoo, is a bit of a chess game. Both of these teams seem to be running their set plays. And it could be very interesting in the second half to see what develops if a little locker room talk goes on and see what these coaches are going to do to try to disrupt each other's systems.
It is. It's a very controlled game. You're seeing two teams that have a serious game plan and they're executing it, putting blocks in place, slowly getting everything in position to do what they want to do to win. However, Nashville is the only team that I have personal experience with. There's something about them. They'll often go to that locker room, and they'll come out, and it seems like something's been retooled. They get fired up. I don't know what it is. Nashville has some way that they, in the past, have come out, rallied, and done amazing things in the second half. Maybe they're a second-half team.
Well, we will see as the second half is yet to come. My name is Lightning Slim. I'm here with my good friend Big Daddy Voodoo. And that is merely the first game of this tournament early in the morning, what I call early in the morning. If you see the game a little differently than we do, you are free to have a word with us. You can use the hashtag on Twitter. That's Talk2WFTDA. And give us a little feedback and tell us how you're enjoying the tournament thus far in this very first bout.
And we would love to share your thoughts on what's going on. So, you know, talk back to us.
Welcome back, folks. If you are just joining us or you forget things easily, you are watching the Division I playoff tournament in Asheville, North Carolina for the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. I am Lightning Slim, and this is Big Daddy Voodoo.
Hello, friends. Wow, what a first half.
We are, of course, talking about the first bout between the Music City All-Stars of Nashville and the Oklahoma Victory Dolls All-Stars. Oklahoma leading 108-249.
Such a controlled, strategic game. That's what we've seen so far. Two teams, you can't call it explosive or necessarily hard-hitting. I mean, although there are
indeed
both of those things. But you can just see both teams examining each other's strategy, outplaying. It's such a great dimension to this game that it makes me so happy to see.
Both teams attempting to exercise some measure of pack control in different ways. Nashville trying to do a speed control, especially during power jams, and Oklahoma quickly reforming front walls from front to back again, and also playing the clock a little by establishing that comfortable lead that they now have and not being afraid to trade when they know they have that lead.
So far in the first half, we've only had we've had two power jams apiece. For the teams, which is amazing. Last week in Richmond, it kept coming up over and over again that penalties were the story. It is so great to see strategy being the story on this particular bout.
Absolutely, and you see, you saw there on your screen just briefly, that was Nashville. They would be wearing the blue in this contest. Oklahoma in the red.
Although penalties being said, in that first half, Nashville has served a total of 15 penalty minutes, while Oklahoma has only served 8.
Oklahoma lining up there on the Antic Boot Jammer line.
Nashville's zip drive scoring 25 points in one jam in the first half, while Oklahoma had a jam that was a 46-point jam scored by Check 1-2.
and currently jamming for Nashville, Four Leaf Roller, and she is joined on the Oklahoma side by number four, Blood Bjorn Pathogen.
I'm sorry, I read my note wrong. That's 46 points scored in the first half by Check 1-2, and Blood Bjorn had 25 points scored in the first half.
30 minutes on the clock, and away they go. Blood Bjorn Pathogen immediately pushed to the outside, as is Four Leaf Roller. A quick recovery. Blood Bjorn Pathogen, lead jammer for Oklahoma.
Four Leaf Roller looking to get around the Oklahoma defense. She gets forced to the inside, and they're making her go the long way.
She was struck to the inside of the oval and forced to recycle herself to the back of the pack. Meanwhile, on a scoring pass, 5 points on the board for Blood Bjorn Pathogen. Oklahoma continuing to extend their lead, hoping to put it out of the reach of Nashville.
Four Leaf Roller trying to get around on the outside earlier of Oklahoma. She's going to clear the pack, and now she's on a scoring pass.
Blood Bjorn Pathogen. Oh, two blockers to beat, but they stumble and fall. She was through, but holding her face, she calls off the jam. She may have taken a shot to the mouth there, and that's what necessitated her calling off the jam.
Liftoff is provided by Durbalife, the official beverage of the WFTDA announcers. It's an all-natural energy drink for skaters and announcers alike. Visit Durbalife.com.
I'm looking over at the Oklahoma bench. It looks like Blood Bjorn Pathogen might have had a few bees in the nose, but they seem to have quickly cleared.
That was 9 points scored on that last pass.
T-Pain, Britches and Hose, jammers of the right now. Inside the pack, T-Pain makes the play to the front, but Britches and Hose is quicker. Britches and Hose, lead jammer.
She's going to lunge out of that pack. Beautiful form as she did everything she could, clears the pack, and now back. It's going to be up to Oklahoma to fight against those Nashville defenders. Nashville, when they get control, they're doing a pretty good job, but those jammers are just getting through more often.
An effective sandwich play holds up T-Pain for just a few more seconds. That allows Britches and Hose to get inside the pack on a scoring pass. She is through. One and done. She'll take it.
Britches and Hose, again, looking to her team. They're opening those textbook holes in the Oklahoma wall and giving her what she needs.
And in this case, what she needed was 4 points. She grabbed them. Nashville up to 53. Oklahoma with a score of 117. 27 and a half minutes remaining in this contest. Zip drive returns to the jammer line. She's been very effective for Nashville. And she faces another effective jammer for Oklahoma. Check 1-2.
I want to thank WFTDA partners Crazy Skate Shop and Green Monster. Thank you so much.
Zip drive struck down. In turn number two, an illegal procedure penalty coming here to an Oklahoma skater. Meanwhile, at the front of the pack, Check 1-2 becomes lead jammer. That was Des Dispenser going to the notorious RED penalty area. Inside the pack, on a scoring pass, Check 1-2 is through. 5 points on the board for Oklahoma. More penalties coming here. Oh, zip drive in turn one, just knocked down.
Nashville, they're taking time when the Oklahoma jammer comes through. They're going to hit the brakes just a little bit, give up on helping their jammer through just to make sure that Check 1-2 is held up as long as they possibly can to give that jammer a chance to get out of that pack.
Mount Crushmore continues to bedevil zip drive. Oh, and zip drive crushed jammer to jammer action as Check 1-2 caught her looking the opposite way as she was about to re-enter the pack. Check 1-2 picking up a penalty, a back-blocking penalty, just a little bit towards the rearward side of Zip Drive as she knocked her down.
And Mount Crushmore goes to the box with a low-blocking penalty.
Zip Drive now on a power jam, but maybe not a lot of gas left in the tank as she's taken tremendous physical punishment in this jam.
She does a little spin move, clears the pack. 5 points picked up by Nashville.
Zip drive, skating cautiously. She seems to be a jammer with visualization skills. She likes to see her way through that pack before she engages. And now simply outwaiting this pack as it gets stretched out. Her teammates bringing up the rear and putting on the brakes to cause that pack to break wide open.
Direction,
zip drive puts up another five.
Direction of gameplay penalty being called on 777. Des Dispenser. So she's going to go to the penalty box. Oklahoma had one player released. Right now, Oklahoma's got a full house in the notorious RED penalty box.
up in Canada, we sometimes call that full penalty box the minivan. Mom driving the kids.
On that last jam, 7 points picked up by Oklahoma. Nashville is going to pick up 10.
And flying solo on that jammer line, Union Jack you up. She has two to beat and does so quite handily. Lead jammer, Union Jack you up of Nashville.
24 minutes, 52 seconds left to go in this game. Nashville 63, Oklahoma 124.
Union Jack you up using her four blockers as a bit of a smoke screen as she re-enters the pack on the power jam. Comes up with 5 points on the other side. And
again,
now re-entering from the penalty area. Check 1-2 is back on the track. Quickly re-engages with the pack.
Stella Live's going to go to the penalty box for Nashville.
And with another 5 points on the board for Union Jack you up, check 1-2 completes her initial pass after returning from the penalty box. Union Jack you up is still in the hunt. She does not seem to have looked in that rearview mirror. She does not see check 1-2. Now she does. Calls off that jam after taking a hit from Esha Spades.
Still alive, picking up that penalty for an out of play. 23 minutes, 58 seconds left to go in the game. Nashville 73, Oklahoma 124. Nashville looking to get those jammers free from that pack a little more often.
Four-leaf roller squares off against Bloodbjorn Pathogen. Nashville still one skater in the penalty box. Bloodbjorn Pathogen making an early play to the front of the pack. She is lead jammer. Four-leaf roller. Lady, gets a whip from Electrical.
Lady Fury getting tied up in two of the Oklahoma blockers. It was actually kind of a dramatic spin that took her out of bounds.
Four-leaf roller absorbs a hit there. That was from number 11, Jenna Tease.
Jenna Tease is going to go down on one knee. She's going to fall to the back of the pack.
Track-cutting penalty coming here. And that track-cutting penalty is being assessed for Leaf Roller. She has not yet seen the referee.
And it was quite an impressive leap that the Oklahoma jammer made over one of the players in her path.
Bloodbjorn Pathogen displaying prowess here. She puts up 5 points. And now, only now, begins this power jam for Oklahoma. A bit stretched out as Four Leaf Roller had not acknowledged the penalty that was assessed to her right away. And Bloodbjorn Pathogen, a chance to widen the lead for Oklahoma, coming around the outside. 5 more points on the board for the ladies in red.
Love Bjorn Pathogen. I mean, she's getting a little bit more fired up. She's really showing a lot of prowess with a great apex leap on the inside.
Also leaping to their feet, her teammates on the bench to celebrate. Bloodbjorn Pathogen, and just as quickly teleports all the way around the track and is inside the pack again before you know it. Knocked down there. Nashville deciding to go to work on her physically.
Bloodbjorn Pathogen's having some words as she goes down on one knee.
Two penalties quickly assessed to the blockers of Nashville as they got physical with Bloodbjorn Pathogen, and that penalty box is full once again.
For Electrical in the box for a cutting track. We'll get it worked out here in just a second.
A difficult situation for Nashville as Oklahoma has sort of maintained that 2-to-1 ratio ever since this second half of play has begun.
25 points picked up by Bloodbjorn Pathogen on that last jam. CruiseSkateShop.com offering quality test derby gear and guidance since 2007.
We have a timeout from Nashville here. You see them receiving instructions at their bench. Also having a bit of a powwow on the track itself, of course, Oklahoma. A timeout for one team is a timeout for all.
And maybe this is just me, but it looked like there's a little fatigue on the faces of the Nashville players in that shot.
They may have received an unpleasant surprise from Oklahoma first thing this morning, Big Daddy.
You know, I did my research, and I tried to find as much on Oklahoma as I could, and I know it is entirely my shortcoming, but maybe some other people had trouble researching.
Jammin' Jane, number 20, takes the jammer line for Oklahoma. She will be solo. And another power jam opportunity for Oklahoma here with 21 minutes remaining. 149 the score for Oklahoma. Nashville sitting at 73.
So in the box right now, Electrical is in the box for misconduct. Tarot Bite Pivot for Nashville is going to be in the box for a cutting track, and Four Leaf Roller is also in the box cutting track.
Jammin' Jane quickly out and picking up lead, coming around the outside to the beat, collides, and receives a back blocking penalty due to that collision with the Nashville blocker.
It's not really going to affect things a lot because Nashville's jammer already back out on the floor. Four Leaf Roller trying to get through those last couple defenders.
Four Leaf Roller does so, and now on a scoring pass, trying to get only one blocker there to help her. Four Leaf Roller now on a scoring pass coming around the outside. Right. 5 points for Four Leaf Roller.
Nashville down to the two defenders on the track, having a lot of trouble managing this power jam.
And a track-cutting penalty coming here to Four Leaf Roller. We will rotate jammers in the box once again. And just as you and I were talking about how the first half was a bit of a chess game full of wonderful strategy, things get a little bashy here in the second.
Yeah, it's really revving up. I mean, as we saw earlier, Blood Bjorn Pathogen really getting fired up in her jamming. And I get the sense that both teams are really starting to feel this clock counting down. 20 minutes, 5 seconds left to go in this game.
Jammin' Jane back from the notorious RED penalty area and scoring now. Finally, some blockers trickling back from the penalty area for Nashville. She has a wall of three to beat. She does so. Gets some jammer support from her blockers. That's 5 more points on the board for Oklahoma. Nashville slowing down things. But if they're not careful, Nashville will break that pack open and allow easy access to Jammin' Jane. Now, they're putting the hip to her.
Nashville jammer back on the floor. Four Leaf Roller manages to catch the tail end of the jam before they're going to reset.
5 more points on the board for Jammin' Jane before that jam came to a close. 19 minutes remain.
Be sure to check out the cheese ball bearing bracket bonanza. I know last week mine was mine was destroyed. I'm hoping better for this week.
Representing for Ginger Nation on the jammer line, we have Dolly Dynamite and Zip Drive.
A dense pack holding up both jammers. No lead jammer as of yet.
Dolly Dynamite up to the front. They have to let her go outside that zone of engagement. Lead jammer, Dolly Dynamite of Oklahoma. Meanwhile, Zip Drive has also escaped the pack and skating in the free and open spaces.
Zip Drive trying to put some pressure on the jammer, Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma. But Dolly Dynamite is looking pretty good at reaching this pack and picking up another 4 points. Let's see.
Dolly Dynamite, tested to the very end by the Nashville defenders. And that allows a steal of four by Nashville right at the end of that jam.
18 minutes, 9 seconds left to go. 163 Oklahoma, Nashville 82.
Britches and Hose jamming for Nashville. You see her there looking down at her opponent, getting low there. That's number 14, T-Pain.
That antique boots start line looking really dense once again.
Indeed, populated by just as many blockers. T-Pain out in front. T-Pain, lead jammer.
Currently, the penalty boxes are empty. We're playing with two full squads right now.
We are 80 wheels strong, but not for long. Leanne Crimes takes a seat.
Yeah, I thought it would be worth pointing it out while it lasted.
It's as if somehow we made that happen.
I take no credit if anyone from Nashville is listening.
Britches and Hose, two to beat at the front of the pack. Trying to put Nashville back within striking distance of Oklahoma. Recycled.
The pack getting stretched out a little bit. It's like they're trying to run away with it.
And T-Pain getting stuck in also. Gets physical with the pivot and comes around the outside. That's 5 points for Oklahoma. Meanwhile, Britches and Hose trying not to be recycled once again. She has one to beat. That's 00. Mount Crushmore puts on a burst of speed, but Mount Crushmore takes her down in turn two.
Britches and Hose had gotten a beautiful little whip off of her teammate. Oh, we have a star pass as Britches and Hose is going to pass that star to her pivot. That's going to be Tarot Bite. Now jammer for Nashville. Tara Byte's going to clear the pack. Oh, but it's called for cutting track. Oh, no, big.
All the distraction of having to avoid hits, skate fairly, and still remain in bounds and put that helmet cover on all at the same time. Bit of a problem for Tara Byte as she will take a seat, and this is now another power jam for Oklahoma.
Oklahoma's going to call off the jam. We're going to reset and do it one more time.
And that will put fresh legs on the track. Check 1-2 will come on for the power start.
Lead the pack with new UV ink printing at printcographics.com. There's number 12, Check 1-2, who we are told is Czech from the Czech Republic, I believe.
And we have a brief official timeout.
Official timeout brought to you by Green Monster. GRNMNSTR.com.
And it looks like we've reset. We're ready to begin once again. A reminder, if you're out in the world, that these video and audio feeds work on your mobile devices. Just access the regular website on your mobile browser.
Another Green Monster official timeout. This half, 33, sorry, Nashville pick up 33, Oklahoma 65. Thank you.
So Oklahoma, having established dominance early on in the first half, does so again in the second half of play and has been more than a handful for Nashville, I should say. Why are they letting me speak in the morning?
Hey, if they let me on here, they figured, we'll let Lightning Slim on if that guy can do it. we're going to have word on this official timeout shortly.
Head referee just sharing the results with the crowd, and we will share that with you momentarily. Just under 60 minutes remaining in this second half of play. And we have an update from Captain Lou Albama.
The Oklahoma Victory Dolls are questioning the number of scoring passes on the previous jam. So they were just looking for a score clarification. We'll see what happens as a result of this official review.
Thank you very much, Captain Lou.
You can see the players already on that start line in the power jam formation.
Indeed, the conga line is already off to one side for Oklahoma.
That perpendicular line is the theory.
It's a blue and red letter L.
It is. It just means they're going to get lead jammer.
L for lead. That's right. Visualization.
Visualization. It's all about visualization.
It's the key word for this morning.
It's Asheville. You know, Asheville's a very open-minded, spiritually aware place. So you've got to bring it to Asheville.
And indeed, a beautiful place.
Oh, it is such a beautiful city. Great food, great drink. It's one of the beer cities, United States.
Captain Lou back on. Confirmed that there were just two scoring passes in the previous jam, so 10 points for the Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Score remains 173-82.
Thank you very much, Captain Lou.
Tara Byte is going to start this jam in the penalty box. She received that star pass, so she's going to sit out as jammer.
Meanwhile, the only jammer on the track, Check 1-2, struck to her knees initially, quickly back on. Forced out in turn number one. Hefty defense there by number 77, Danny Doom. But Check 1-2 is not deterred. Quickly gets stuck back into the pack. Defenders at the front to beat. You see her patiently pushing ahead, trying to move that wall in front of her like a shopping cart. One more to beat. Union Jack, you up at the front of the pack. Check 1-2. She has gained that lead jammer status, but was momentarily reabsorbed by Union Jack. You up now, skating in the free and open spaces. You do not see her on your screen because she's making her way around the mountain on a scoring pass.
I have a good time watching Lady Fury lay down a hit sometimes because it's like she's pushing a refrigerator uphill.
She is a diminutive blocker, but capable of some physical play, certainly.
She will turn and put her whole body into a block. It's beautiful.
And Check 1-2 runs over Union Jack You Up right at the end of that jam and decides that she has taken her points and taken her territory and calls it off.
Fast Girl Skates. Our mission is educating skaters. Get schooled. FastGirlSkates.com.
14 and a half minutes remaining in the contest. Oklahoma 177, Nashville a score of 82. And a roar from the crowd here, a bit of a cheering section wearing the blue of the Nashville Roller Girls.
Taro Byde clearing the penalty box. She's going to be back in play.
But it is Blood Bjorn Pathogen, number four for Oklahoma, who has become your lead jammer. Taro Byde also skating free. The pack getting a bit spread out here.
Those Nashville fans, they'll follow this team all over. I've gone to Cincinnati and found a full contingent of Nashville fans in the house. They were actually holding up a sign that said WKRP sucks.
Number four gets four. Bloodbjorn Pathogen making a scoring pass there, continuing to skate. Meanwhile, Taro Byde skating as a jammer, not her accustomed position, I'm given to understand, and she's getting some physical punishment from the defenders of Oklahoma there, like Dez Dispenser putting the shoulder into her.
She had received that star as a star pass in the previous jam, went to the penalty box, and so now she's kind of struggling starting off as a jammer, which is not her usual job.
She is indeed running up against skaters like Mount Crushmore at the front of the Oklahoma defensive wall. And Bloodbjorn Pathogen puts up five more points on that scoring pass. Oklahoma now, 100 points ahead of Nashville. With 13 minutes remaining, Bloodbjorn Pathogen skates on. Taro Byde has yet to escape from this pack. She has been held within by Oklahoma.
Yeah, Taro Byde's having a lot of trouble getting past that seasoned line. They just keep recycling her back, and she'll start to break free. They'll lure her in and lock her down and recycle her back again.
Mount Crushmore gives a little whip to her jammer, Bloodbjorn Pathogen, and then goes right back to work on Taro Byde. Five more points on the board for Oklahoma. Taro Byde looking for jammer support from her blockers. You see a few whispered instructions, but the jam comes to an end.
Electrical picking up a forearm call at the end of that jam. So that's going to put Nashville down by one blocker when they start this next jam. Fifthblockerskates.co.uk. Don't be scunnered. We got 100 of stuff at Fifth Blocker Skates.
Four-leaf roller and Jammin' Jane take to the jammer line. You see both of them getting very low. You couldn't see them behind the wall of blockers in front of them from that camera angle. Four-leaf roller tries to push those defenders. She's trying to outweight that pack until a no-pack is declared. That's what happens. Four-leaf roller, lead jammer, meanwhile recycled to the back of the pack. Jammin' Jane struck down to the inside of turn number two.
The hits are picking up. It's getting more violent, but still, these teams are sticking with that strategic play. It's great to see. I remember the olden days watching Nashville. It was just the bruisers, the laying down the big hits. Oh, my goodness.
There was a bit of a schmozzle of penalties early on in this second half, and it looks like we may have attracted more merely by mentioning the word, Big Daddy. Jammin' Jane coming through the pack there, two to beat, runs into Doom and Union Jack you up.
Yeah.
Union Jack you up gets an out-of-play penalty for engaging in contact with the jammer there, and she will find no room at the end when she arrives at that penalty box.
That's right. Four-leaf roller jammer went to the box for cutting track. Britches and Hose is there for a low block. Who else do we have in the
Danny
box?
Doom is lonely, blocking solo for Nashville.
Electrical is in the box for a forearm call. And now on deck to come in will be Union Jack you up, who's going to go to the box for an out of play.
Jammin' Jane doing some damage on this power jam, putting Oklahoma past the 200-point mark. Takes a hip check there from Danny Doom. Danny Doom, who had to hold down the fort all alone, finally gets Electrical back to help her. But Jammin' Jane skates on. You see her there. Two to beat, spins around the outside. Thinks about calling it off, but thinks maybe she can squeeze a little more out of this jam.
Nashville's pivot and their jammer, four-leaf roller, return to the track. Four-leaf roller just picking up 5 points. She's not going to be able to hold on to lead jammer.
No, as the jam has run out of time.
Oklahoma's going to pick up five more in that last pass through the pack. 9 minutes, 47 seconds left to go. 219-92 in favor of Oklahoma.
Now, Nashville has been doing it by spoonfuls, but they've just received a heavy blow there in the form of that previous power jam, Big Daddy.
28 points picked up by Oklahoma in that last power jam.
And that was Jammin' Jane doing the skating.
Brew Skate Noose, the original over-the-shoulder roller skate holder.
The Redheads return Zip Drive and Dolly Dynamite.
The bag whoop. The shirt whip is one of the Oklahoma skaters' shirt is taking quite a pounding. Don't want to have a wardrobe malfunction in the jam.
Zip Drive makes her way to the front of the pack. She picks up lead. Dolly Dynamite not far behind, so both jammers are now have cleared the pack, and the pack has picked up speed. This is a little more reminiscent of the play we saw in the first half.
Right. They've seemed to have fallen back into that rhythm and are, again, chipping away at each other, although Nashville's going to have to chip a little faster with those jammers. With only 8 minutes, 49 seconds left to go, they have a lot of points to make up.
Zip Drive gets stuck within the pack, calls it off, and we're almost at evens with her picking up 2 points and a one-point steal by Oklahoma. A 2-1 jam there.
8 minutes, 27 seconds left to go.
Riches and Hose. You see her there, number 308, the captain of Nashville. She takes the jammer line against number 14, T-Pain.
Liftoff is provided by Durba Life, the official beverage of the WFTDA announcers.
Britches and Hose having some difficulty with the front wall. Lady Fury holds up T-Pain as long as she can, but T-Pain is lead. The pack is picking up speed, another fast-moving pack. You see T-Pain signaling to her blockers as she comes around the mountain, but she sees Britches and Hose sneaking up on her there. Oh,
ooh,
Britches and Hose, a little contact.
Little love tap, Britches and Hose. Right now, Oklahoma really just needing
and
to...
And now Britches and Hose overtakes T-Pain, and T-Pain willing to play the clock and lets that play itself out before calling off the jam.
I think we're going to see a lot of that as Oklahoma will get in a skate off. They're just going to say, okay, I'll skate with you as long as you want. Those jammers want to sit on that other jammer, prevent them from getting to that pack, and just run that clock down.
The clock is Oklahoma's friend with their score of 220. Nashville with a score of 94. However, 7 minutes, quite a bit of roller derby time as Four Leaf Roller returns to the track facing check 1-2. And a timeout being called here, a timeout for Nashville.
So the teams are going to put their heads together and try to retool for the stretch to the end, the last 7 minutes of this first bout of the Asheville Division I playoff.
One more playoff tournament to come, and that is in Salem, Oregon, coming up. After this one, we are in the middle of what have been 7 playoff tournaments for the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. 60 leagues involved. A lot of roller derby being played. I think we've seen roller derby of the very highest caliber. Some agony and ecstasy in the previous weeks.
And such a wonderful variety of play styles. Just watching teams with a totally different philosophy play against each other has been such a thrill.
And it looks like we're ready to start again.
Hey, a little bit of trivia. The anchor on the Oklahoma Victory Dolls uniform, that's attributed to the USS Oklahoma.
There we go, a Navy connection.
And Nashville, their travel team is actually the Music City All-Stars, which, of course, refers to Nashville, Music City, period. It's Music City.
They make music there.
They make music.
We were given to understand this.
I've been there. There is a lot of music.
Oh, with a bit of a spin, Four Leaf Roller is forced out of bounds. Check 1-2, taking some punishment of her own. And check 1-2 manages to keep it wheel side down and is lead jammer.
Both teams are skating at full power. No one in the penalty box. Both squads are at 100% right now.
Inside the pack, Four Leaf Roller talking with Electrical, looking for some jammer support. Mount Crushmore keeping an eye on, presenting an obstacle for Four Leaf Roller.
Oh, a little bit of a bobble. One of the Oklahoma players is going to fall down. She's going to hop right back up.
That was Dunk of Shame, and she actually got involved in a collision with her own skater, Mount Crushmore.
Oh, no.
Bit of a miscalculation, but she's quickly back to her skates.
So she's going to call off that jam. There's a cutting track called at the tail end of that. I haven't.
Right at the end.
I haven't
matched Crushmore, the player. Number 11 for Oklahoma, picks up a track cutting penalty. So she has been an absolutely ferocious blocker, normally playing pivot for Oklahoma, but they're not going to have her in this jam.
This official timeout is being brought to you by Green Monster. That's GRNMNSTR.com. When we come back, when we start back, 5 minutes, 39 seconds left to go in this game.
And the next bout in the tournament coming up after this one, you will see Houston Roller Derby taking on the Columbia Quad Squad. Houston seeded seventh, and Columbia, the last seed in the tournament's number 10.
The winner of this game will advance to game 5 later today, and they're going to be playing Gotham Girls Roller Derby. And I know that a lot of locals are really excited about that. Gotham doesn't really play in this general area of the country. So this is the first time that some of the local derby skaters are going to get to see Gotham.
And if you would like to see that bout, that will be happening at 8 p.m. this very evening.
Sounds like we're back. The referee blowing the whistle to alert us that we're about ready to start.
And with a bit of reassessment, this is now a power jam for Nashville. Check 1-2 is sitting in the penalty box.
She's going to be in the penalty box for back blocking. And
Zip Drive out in lead. Zip Drive heading towards the pack. You see there at the bottom of your screen, you will see Zip Drive. She's going towards her own wall, giving some instructions. Her blocker moves up, breaks up that wall in front of her. Zip Drive coming around the outside. There she goes, and we have some clarification here from Captain Lou.
Yes, that back block that you noticed at the end of the last jam was to check 1-2. She's in the penalty box. Power jam, Nashville.
I believe we also have Genetees in the box. I believe that was a cutting track that she went to the box for.
Zip Drive on a scoring pass. She has put up points. She will put up more. That's what she is aiming for. Takes a hip check there from number 21, Esha Spades. Manages to wend her way through the pack. That's another 5 points for Nashville. And now Nashville up over the 100-point mark. 221 to 109, the current score with 4.5 minutes remaining.
Nashville right now skating one blocker short as they have a player in the box.
Meanwhile, returning from that box, Oklahoma skaters, including their jammer. The power jam is over. We have an attempted star pass as Check 1-2 tries to hand the helmet cover to Bloodbjorn Pathogen, does so successfully, and off goes Bloodbjorn Pathogen. But the jam is over.
4 points picked up by Nashville on that last pass. And we're going to set up again at the Antic Boots jammer line. 24 points picked up in that last jam by Oklahoma.
And with just under 4 minutes remaining, Oklahoma 221. Nashville bringing their score up to 118.
And that's going to be a timeout being called by Nashville.
An official review.
Oh, I'm sorry. My mistake.
And you see there, Team Zebra having a discussion at the center of the oval with the captains and their coaches. And some consultation with the penalty board. For you stats hounds at home, that's a rare opportunity for you to get full view of that penalty board right there on camera.
So the loser of this game will go on to play on game 8 Saturday, right? Against the loser of game number 4.
And that will be at 10 a.m. on Saturday morning.
Cool.
Returning to the jammer line, as she was not jamming for much of the previous jam, number 4 for Oklahoma, Bloodbjorn Pathogen. And Captain Lou might have some more clarification for us. Captain.
Yeah, Nashville is arguing that there was a back block by the Oklahoma jammer in the previous jam. They will see if they can get that call and try to get another power jam out of it.
Thank you.
So that could work out in their favor if the officials see it that way. That could be a big break for Nashville. It looks like they're about ready to wrap up this official review.
Nashville's bench there. Some focus on those faces. And now we see whatever decision has been made being explained
These officials are amazing. I was in Richmond last week. This week I'm here in Asheville, and these officials are absolutely pro, top of their game.
And that's head referee Curtis Elay now clarifying, and Captain Lou has the scoop on that.
Yes, so the argument was that just before the star pass happened, a back block had occurred. Referees did not agree with that. There will be no call, and the game will continue with both jammers on the track.
Well, Nashville tried to get the advantage. Didn't quite work in their favor at this particular moment. And 3 minutes, 49 seconds left to go in the game. 221 Oklahoma, 118 Nashville.
And so facing Bloodbjorn Pathogen is Britches and Hose. Bloodbjorn Pathogen makes a very quick play to the inside line, but is rebuffed. And that allows Britches and Hose to face the final two at the front of the pack. Takes a hit from Mount Crushmore. And his lead jam for Nashville.
And that's going to send Mount Crushmore to the box. I believe that was an out-of-play penalty she picked up.
A little bit late as she tried to hold up Britches and Hose. Britches and Hose is being gained on by Bloodbjorn Pathogen. And both of them having trouble keeping up with an extremely fast-moving pack.
This pack has some place to be. They are really taking off right now. And that's going to end that jam.
And with nothing neither way, as those jammers are unable to catch them.
So you can go ahead and start updating your Cheeseball Bearings Bracket Bonanza, cheeseballs.com. Start filling them in. We got a lot of work to do on our brackets this weekend.
Jammin' Jane. Oh, Jammin' Jane was going to jam. She switches places very quickly with T-Pain.
Oh, a timeout has been called.
That's timeout Oklahoma.
So we're going to take another minute. Well, what we saw at the first half, which was two very meticulous teams, I don't know if maybe they were feeling each other out and getting a sense of their style for the second half. But the second half has been a little bit looser, a little bit harder hitting. Occasionally they'll pull back in and you'll see that control, that extreme control both teams had at the beginning. Fascinating texture of this game.
Yeah, I think you will see them sort of default to that control position that they had, but then emotions might get the better of them. Nashville now with just 2.5 minutes left might have to play in a desperation situation, and they might have to throw some of the more elaborate strategies out the window. They've got a lot of lifting to do with Oklahoma, a score of 221 to Nashville's 118.
Bright side for Nashville. Nashville has held Oklahoma to 2 points over the last five jams. So they're doing something right. They just need to pick up that momentum and really start putting those
and
points
and make no mistake, Nashville has played some excellent roller derby
doubtless
this morning.
Without a doubt.
And also playing some excellent roller derby right now, Four Leaf Roller, your lead jammer.
Four Leaf Roller's been really busy today. She's picked up a lot of Nashville's points.
And she is being chased by number 14, T-Pain, but it is Four Leaf Roller on her scoring pass. Oklahoma trying to pick up the speed of the pack and keep it out of the reach of Four Leaf Roller. Four Leaf Roller has rejoined her teammates and is looking for support, gets it there. They form some spaces for her. She calls it off and picks up two in the process.
It's a responsibility for both teams to keep that pack integrated. So when one team takes off with that speed, it's the responsibility of the other team to stay within that 10-foot, 20-foot range to keep the integrity of that pack. If they don't keep the integrity of that pack, that's when the out-of-play penalties start getting assigned.
And that was good communication from Four Leaf Roller. When she hit the pack, she called for her blocker, Hippie Kaye, to move forward and break up that wall for her, and that's exactly what Hippie did. Great teamwork on both sides.
Bodies go flying. A minute and 21 seconds left to go in the game. 221 Oklahoma, 120 Nashville. Jamming for Nashville. It's going to be Zip Drive.
Zip Drive, three in front of her to beat. Her teammates lollygagging a bit to maybe extend the pack as far as possible so they will let Zip Drive go.
Jamming Jane trying to get through the pack for Oklahoma. Still no lead jammer at this moment. Cutting track has been assigned.
Oh, and a stumble there.
Lady Fury picks up that cutting track. She's going to go to the penalty box for Nashville.
Jammin' Jane fell and was left behind by the pack. She takes a whip there so that she can re-engage with some speed. And now Jammin' Jane, after all this time, is lead jammer. Both jammers with a big fight on their hands to get out of the pack. And Zip Drive has been recycled.
You know, that is the longest I think I've seen it take lead jammer to be resolved in the last... I was in Richmond last week. That is the longest I've seen in this turn in a tournament.
But we were through the whole first minute, indeed, before Jammin' Jane was able to pick up lead status. She is on her scoring pass, but looks perhaps unwilling or unable to catch up with the pack. There she goes now with one blocker to beat in the back, but there's a two wall in the front. Union Jack, you're up with an elegant hit there, putting her out in turn number two. And she calls off the jam with 3 points.
The clock has run out. We have a timeout called by Nashville. So we might be getting one more jam.
I'm sure that was Nashville's motivation. They want that jam. They want to put that differential to bed and get themselves just a little bit closer to Oklahoma. Oklahoma with a score of 223, Nashville 120.
Okay, so
Oklahoma has maintained position on the track because they are expecting Nashville to force an additional jam.
So chipping in.
If you want to hit us up on Twitter and tell us about your playoff experience and how we're doing this morning, please tag your posts with the hashtag WFTDA Playoffs, WFTD Playoffs Asheville, or you can talk directly to us at hashtag talk numeral 2 WFTDA. And yes, we're going to get one more jam, ladies and gentlemen.
And I know a lot of people have, at bouts that I've announced, have said, well, why do they keep fighting to the very end? It's because these points are very important. The spread is, if you can't win, you have to keep that spread as low as possible.
Indeed, the yearly rankings of these teams depend on these differential rankings that they're going to get by these scores they gain in these tournaments. These all count. And number 55 for Oklahoma, Dolly Dynamite, lead jammer in this, which is for sure the final jam.
Nashville at 120, Oklahoma 223, 103-point difference.
And Dolly Dynamite, of course, calling it off as she gains lead and securing the victory for Oklahoma.
Wow, what a fascinating game. What a fascinating play style. I love the mix of strategy, control, yet the fury that both teams released on each other.
Indeed, the smiling faces you see there for Oklahoma, they're taking their victory lap. The victory dolls, the all-stars of Oklahoma.
And the Nashville Music City all-stars. What a great effort. This was, their fifth in a row? Yes, this was their fifth trip to a playoff tournament in a row. In 2012, they lost South Central in the fifth game.
Nashville coming in as the eighth seed, nominally upset by the ninth seed, Oklahoma. Oklahoma making a statement early on here in Asheville. Did it with panache as Oklahoma established an early lead in the first period of play. Nashville made an effective comeback right towards the halfway mark, and then Oklahoma really, really turned down the screws and established dominance in the second half, Big Daddy.
And Nashville, even though they didn't come out with the points, they had such great control of that pack. They really tried to force Oklahoma to play their game, to keep control and put them where they wanted. It just sometimes comes down to your jammers.
But not to take anything away from the Nashville squad, who are maturing in their pack control ability also, and they did a very effective job of that in this bout. But there is your final, folks, 224 Oklahoma, Nashville 120. And warming up on the track right now, our next bout, that will be Houston versus Columbia.
So in this, the winner of this bout is going to go on to play Gotham Girls Roller Derby. That's tonight at 8 o'clock.
Indeed,
right?
Yes.
And the loser is now going to go, or Nashville is going to go to Game 8, who's going to play. They're going to play on Saturday against the loser of Game 4. So we have a lot of roller derby left to go.
That is, yeah, that's one bout in the bag for this tournament. Many more to come. We hope you will remain with us all weekend on WFTDA.TV. And we're going to take it down to trackside now with Inspector Muffin. He has an interview with Oklahoma Jammer Check 1-2. I'm Lightning Slim. He's Big Daddy Voodoo. Keep enjoying.
Hey there, I'm Inspector Muffin. I am joined by Jammer Check 1-2 of the Oklahoma Victory Dolls. First off, congratulations on the big win today over the 8-seed Nashville Roller Girls. Did you guys do anything differently to prepare for this tournament?
We definitely did. We upped our practice. We practiced more than we ever had, and we held each other accountable. If you weren't there and you didn't fill out our data sheet as to why you weren't there, we were calling and texting and making sure everyone showed up. We worked out, we dieted, we took this. I mean, this is our biggest opportunity, and we took it that way.
Awesome. You guys played fantastically. 224 to 120, doubled up on them, basically. Now, this isn't your first tournament this season. You guys actually started the year with the Clover Cup. You went 3-0 with the Clover Cup, beating Tallahassee in the championship game. How did that season-opening tournament propel you through the 2013 season?
We did not expect to win. We never expect to win. In the past, when we have, we've always, it's been our worst games. So coming into that in the middle, expecting to just stay where we are, and then propelling all the way to the top, we knew what we were capable of, and so we took that momentum here, still not expecting to win, but knowing that we have potential as long as we work as a team, and teamwork is huge for us. And so that's really, I mean, we bond, we work together, and we saw we could do it at Clover Cup, so we're going to bring all of that here.
Yeah, you spoke, Check 1-2, of their close teamwork. Now, I noticed Oklahoma kind of goes with a kind of out-of-sync lineups on the track. You use a five-jammer rotation, and those skaters do not play in the pack. So you're asking a lot out of your pack players, but how nice is it as a jammer to be able to play every fifth jam?
It's really nice because we're all different jammers, and so we're not all going to be as effective against different teams. So it takes off the pressure of either you're good or you're not, because you know someone can cover you. And then also, I don't know if you noticed, but this was a really fast game, and so we got enough time in between to rest with that five jammer rotation. I know that's really unique to us, but just with the rules change and all of that, this is what we found to be the most effective way to stay with enough energy throughout the whole bout.
Up next, I know you want to celebrate the victory against Nashville, but you've got the number one team in the world for basically the last 3 years, Gotham Roller Girls, Gotham Roller Derby. Oklahoma is a very unfamiliar team to most viewers around the globe. What can they expect out of you girls against Gotham?
They can expect us to be really happy to be playing them, and we're going to stick with what works for us, which is working together as a team. That's our most important thing, and as long as we can keep doing that, I really feel like we're going to show everyone that we did come prepared, and we are ready.
Well, you definitely looked prepared out there in the first game, the first upset of the weekend here in Nashville, North Carolina. This is Check 1-2. I'm Inspector Muffin. Up next, the 7-10 game. I'm sorry. Yes, the 7-10 game. We have Columbia going up against Houston. Stay tuned, WFTDA-TV.
Told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put three W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.